I'm the best ever. There's never been anybody ruthless. I'm Sonny Liston. I'm Jack Dempsey. There's no one like me. I'm from Nairclough. There's no one that can match me.
West Indies team, two very big press conferences today. I'm delighted to welcome two gold medalist Olympians to the hotel today. Firstly up, to my left, James De Gale. We're delighted to announce we'll face Marco Antonio Peribán at the Liverpool Echo Arena on November the 22nd, part of a huge card on Sky Sports box office. And we're delighted to welcome James today. To his left, obviously a man who's instrumental in James's development, someone who we've worked with a long time at Matchroom, been involved with some great super middleweights over the years, of course, Ambrose Mendy. And to his right, someone who is potentially, or definitely even more, instrumental in his development and someone who has guided him from an early stage in his career now to the point of almost challenging for a world title, Jim McDonnell, his trainer. Just want to talk briefly about the situation for James De Gale. It's a very, very interesting one. One that's taken 4 or 5 months since that fine performance at Wembley Stadium when he beat Brandon Gonzalez to become the IBF mandatory challenger for Carl Froch to this moment. And it's been a waiting game for James De Gale. We know what he wants. He wants a shot at that world title. And he's earned that shot now. He's a mandatory challenger. It's not going anywhere. And now he waits patiently, so far, for a shot at Carl Froch. Personally, I believe that fight's going to happen. We have a little friendly bet down between everyone here at the table. It's a fight I want to see. It's a fight I believe the British public wants to see. I know our broadcasters want to see as well. But I have to take my hat off to James De Gale and the team because he didn't want to wait around. And you know, my advice was probably take a much easier fight than Marco Antonio Peribán. 20-2, Mexican, I think number 10 in the WBC rankings. You saw him lose a very tight decision to Sapio Beaker for the WBC title. Obviously went there, drew with Badu Jack, and then had J.Leon Love everywhere before losing a tight decision to him. So he's here to win. It's a very, very tough fight, and James puts it all on the line. That number one position in the IBF is up for grabs, and Peribán's coming here to take that. He wants his shot, bro. But James De Gale wanted to make sure he made a real statement on November the 22nd. And we feel that Marco Antonio Peribán is the perfect opponent to do so. So firstly, to talk a little bit about the fight itself and James' development. Jim?
Basically, I think Eddie's given you the pull down and everything. First of all, with James, obviously he's mandated for the IBF title, and that's the title he wants to fight for. James is an unknown fighter, I don't know, in terms of what gets him up, what gets him down. He could have took a different fight, as Eddie just explained, but he gets motivated by fighting the best, and he wants to be the best. All I can say, and I'm going to keep it short and brief, is I watched him even yesterday, and just the difference in him since he's gone through stuff with Gary Lewis and all that thing in boxing. A few problems for probably the best part of 6, 7 months, 8 months. And right now, the best James De Gale is yet to come. I think he's coming towards the world title level when you're going to see the guy who won the Olympic gold medal, which I don't give away, won it in Beijing. And the fact is, you look at James now, how round he is as a professional fighter, everything he's doing, the tempo he boxes at. I think right now you're looking at the best 6, 8 pound fighter in the world. I hope the conference what happens. British boxing, I think it'd be like, great for everyone to tune in and watch. And I think it would also be like that for James De Gale is when they see the performance he puts in when he wins that world title.
And Ambrose, the call in my side. 28,000 calls a day, emails, harassment. Obviously, you wanted James to have a big fight on the 22nd.
Yeah, he's got it. Indeed. And I might say, I am a former Eddie side. Because I have a job to do, and it's pretty invisible around James. But, you know, my job is to ensure that James gets where he was destined to be in the shortest possible time. And sometimes it is very, very frustrating. His levels of skill, you know, some of you in this room have no idea. You know, Anthony Joshua is going to come up here in a moment, and he will beat the mentor from where James is at. James De Gale, Jim said it, is the number one 168 guy in the world. When James becomes world champion, and oblivious to what Carl Froch may say, think or do, he is going to become world champion. The mandate then will be to Eddie, very simple, go and get the Andre Walls of this world, you know, bring George Groves out of his hibernation and deluded self. Because that's what Jones wants to do, wants to give to the British public what they demand, what they want, great domestic fights. Whenever we reflect back, we look and know domestic fights mean everything. Las Vegas means asking everybody to get up, those that stay at home, watch boxing 4 or 5 o'clock in the morning. Who wants it when we can do it here? You know, the press conference following this is again about great domestic talent. So, I might bore some people, I have a job to do. And my job is to convince everybody in here just how great James DeGale is. And believe you me, he is the person who selected the opponent. You know, does Jim have any misgivings about it? No, because James' mindset is that he wants Carl Froch in a ring. Carl Froch is making every excuse, and I'm not going to be polite about it. He's a great fighter, probably the most financially successful super middleweight in the history of boxing worldwide. However, we've come to an abrupt halt with regards to James. Carl Froch, listening, watching on that camera there, I'm not here to insult you, but what I am saying is, few tins of man up, mate. You know, you knew in May that James DeGale was your mandatory. And it's a word which has become quite well established, particularly in boxing circles, courtesy of George Groves. He said it and said it and said it. James is the mandatory for the IBF 168 title. Carl Froch is a title holder. He's been dancing around on some programme. He didn't even win. And now he's pontificating. He's thinking about, Carl, great fighters, and I've been around some, don't pontificate. They get on and do it. Especially when millions of pounds are being guaranteed for the guy to fight. So James doesn't want me to harp on about Carl Froch. I want to harp on about it because I know this guy, the pride of his country, went to Beijing, won an Olympic gold medal, came back British, European, you know, WBC silver, mandatory. James gave that up in order to become the mandatory to who he believed would be Carl Froch. And that is at the back of the mind. What he's going to do now, when it comes to training, is whoever's in the way, he's getting them out of the way. This is a very, very tough, seasoned opponent, a very, very durable Mexican who has fought competitively for the 168 title, WBC, and he'll come here to win. He's not on 2 weeks' notice. He's going to come here to win. James will be left to do what he does, and he'll do it very well. So,
That's just a little taster of the daily conversations with Andrew. They're very passionate, and we've enjoyed the journey so far, and looking forward to the rest of it, Andrew. James, obviously, you know, we know your feelings about Carl Froch. You want that fight badly. For now, November the 22nd, Liverpool Echo Arena, place you've boxed before. Marco Antonio Peraban, arguably toughest fight of your career.
100%. This is like second and final limit, really, because if I don't beat him, I don't box for a while time. So, yeah, this is like another final limit for me, but it's a good test. And Mark Perry Vance, his last few fights has come off 2 losses, but against good quality opposition. He lost points to Zeko Lipa, which was close without matching it, and he lost to Leon Love on points again. But he had Leon Love all over the place in the 5th round. Should have really took him out. But a good season pro. It's half Mexican, not a typical Mexican. He can box well, he can box in the back foot. But he's going to come to fight. And I think he really is going to bring the best out of me. And I'm looking forward to it. It's on a great show. And yeah, Roland 27.
Obviously, you got your reservations about if Froch will fight him. But you know, we said to you, you know, before the fight, if you take the fight on the 22nd of November, the fight with Froch, if it happens, will be January 31st at the O2. Are you okay with that? Will you be ready? And the answer is, of course,
yeah. Yeah, I said, yeah. I said to Eddie actually said to me, why aren't you boxing just 8 or 10, just keep busy fight? I told him, no, I don't want that. I want someone that when I beat, I'm going to get the credit for. And we had a little list. Perry Brown was the one, and I think it's a real good test for me, a real good test, and if I beat him in style, which I will do, I think it sets up a massive showdown with me and Karl Kroc. But as I said in previous interviews, it's not about me boxing Karl Kroc, it's about me just getting my chance, my shot at a world title, becoming the first British Olympic gold medalist to win a world title, making history, and that's what it's about.
Thank you, James. And before we break for one-on-ones, just to clarify the timings issue with the IBF at the moment, Karl Froch or James Degale cannot box after December the 31st. That's the cut-off date. If Karl Froch wanted to box after, he has to ask, put in a petition for an exception, which James can challenge as well. So he knows that on the 31st of December, he will receive a letter from the IBF to say, now you must start negotiations with James Degale for the title. So we know that Karl has never been a fan of vacating titles. Again, it's a fight that I think the British public want, and I'd like to see happen in the early part of 2015. And I know that Karl particularly is excited about the Gale Peribane fight and wants James to go out and really make some noise. So November the 22nd, some huge fights on the card already, some huge fights to be announced on that Tony Bell, you'll be Nathan Cleverly card at Echo Arena. And we look forward to seeing you there. We're going to break for 5 or 10 minutes for one-on-ones with James DeGale, and then we'll bring in the next press conference. Thank you.